Oh, I'm having a ball. I can't believe it. This is something I waited for all my life.
What do you like about it?
Well, it's like the Woodstock of the traditional jazz. It just goes on and on and on. I can't believe it.
Oh, it's absolutely marvelous.
Are you a longtime traditional jazz fan?
Yes, all my life, I think.
What do you like about it?
Everything. It makes my life worth living.
Dan, are you having a good time?
Yeah.
You like this kind of music?
Oh, yes. I think it's real neat.
What kind of... I'm having a great time.
What were these people enjoying so much? For the first time, Dixieland New Orleans musicians and their intensely loyal fans held a jazz festival devoted exclusively to their world of music. Named the World Championship of Jazz, 96 of the greatest jazz artists from 3 countries and 25 states gathered together to play their hearts out for 2,000 die-hard followers.
Is there a number one all-star world championship jazz band?
I'd have to admit no, that there's not. Throughout the world, including Japan and Brazil and Argentina, of course England, Germany, you'll find New Orleans jazz. And New Orleans jazz is a particular art form where on one given night, one given day, one given moment, one band happens to rise to an occasion and blow maybe better than anybody ever did. But who's to know? Because the next night it's a whole new ballgame.
The World Championship of Jazz was held in 4 locations simultaneously in Indianapolis, Indiana. The 15 bands rotated from room to room, drawing inspiration from the different atmospheres and audiences. Let's go now to the Athenaeum Gardens, where the late great trumpeter Smokey Stover and piano man Bob Hirsch are leading their own hand-picked all-stars playing at the Jazz Band Ball.
Thank you.
Traditional jazz has at its roots a variety of sources, not the least of which was spiritual music. A great band, Max Colley's Rhythm Aces from London, England, revives the spirit with the classic Light from the Lighthouse.
Let the light from the lighthouse shine on me. Oh, the Lord has done just what he said. Let the light from the lighthouse shine on me. Well, he's healed the sick and he's raised the dead. Let the light from the lighthouse shine on me. You're gonna let it shine on. Well, let it shine on, Lord. Let the light from the lighthouse shine on me. Let it shine on.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you kindly. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Following the Rhythm Aces was the Queen City Jazz Band from Denver, Colorado, led by trombonist Alan Fredrickson.
Alan, your group just played one of the greatest sets that was heard at this World Championship of Jazz. Why'd you do it?
Well, you see, when we're playing, we get excited. And the audience excites the band, and the band excites the audience, and this is kind of a regenerative thing, like regenerative feedback. And it works toward a musical climax.
You know something? I think you like it.
It would be real fun if I could take this audience with me every place I play and be able to say to the boss, you see?
He may do it, too. Over here on the, I think maybe you ought to know who these guys are, if you don't. All veterans and legends, really, in our kind of music. On the clarinet over here from New York, I guess he still lives there, Sal Pace. Billy Maxted. Jack Lesberg. Cliff Lehman. Abe Lincoln on trombone. Wild Bill Davison. They're going to take off on a Louis Armstrong thing called strutting with some barbecue.
Thank you.
Wild Bill's group, as did the majority of musicians present, received their inspiration from the originators of the New Orleans style of jazz. The New Orleans Joymakers, led by Sweden's Orange Kellen and featuring the ageless Father Al Lewis on banjo, typify this French Quarter spirit.
Thank you, music lovers, our ladies, what you brought along with you. And gents, thank you.
Out of the same era, but taking a different path to stardom, was the great Joe Venuti. One of the grand old men of jazz, Joe Venuti is now in his 80s, and probably as active today as he has been for many years. Joe started out by being born on a boat en route to this country from Italy. He's left a deathless mark on music. He had his own large dance band for years in the 1930s. Today, he mostly plays for festivals and other jazz special events. His most recent story, and he's full of them, tells of entering a bluegrass fiddle contest and taking second place. Not a bad performance for a jazz man. On piano is Marion McPartland. Marion is considered one of the top jazz musicians in the world, the reigning queen of the piano, and one of the very few women who made it in a field completely dominated by men. In 1944, she left her native England to join a USO group in France and thus began her career. It was at the USO that she met American cornetist Jimmy McPartland, whom she later married, and with whom she came to the United States. She worked with Jimmy from 1946 to 1950, and in 1951 formed her own trio, appearing in clubs throughout the country. She's active in radio and television, both as a performer and as a disc jockey, writes record reviews and features for various publications, writes and arranges music, owns her own record company, and in 1963 became one of the first few women to play with the Benny Goodman Sextet. Bassman Eddie DeHaas is a Chicagoan, noted for his supreme taste and technical ability. He also played, as did drummer Barrett Deems, with the Indianapolis All-Stars throughout the festival. Barrett Deems was Louis Armstrong's drummer for many, many years, touring the world with him in 1953 to 1956. 1976 found Barrett Deems again touring Europe, but with another legend, Benny Goodman. We'll pick up with Joe demonstrating an unusual bowing style on a tune just called The Blues, and follow it with Undecided.
Thank you.
McFarland, Joe Venuti.
The World Championship of Jazz swung on throughout the night, with jam sessions going on after hours at the Stauffer Hotel. Informal, but fun, 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 and music, music, music can be witnessed with a New York group, the Speakeasy Jazz Babies, holding the stage. The Jazz Babies include Barbara Horowitz on tuba and frequently appear with comedian clarinetist Woody Allen. The final event was Sunday afternoon. The beautiful theater of the Murat Shrine Temple showcased the six finalists as they played to determine the most popular group. The Bob Hirsch, Smokey Stover All-Stars, and the Wild Bill Davison All-Stars had finished their sets as we pick up the action with the Queen City Jazz Band. Thank you. From their home base at the Sticky Wicket Pub in Boston came a fine, young, but exceptionally talented group called the New Black Eagles Jazz Band. They, of all American bands, expressed the unique blend of old New Orleans jazz with the freshness and exuberance of today's generation.
This is a great tune, we think. It's called The Mooch.
Ha ha.
The original Salty Dogs had their beginnings here in the Hoosier State. While attending Purdue University, the Salty Dogs gained fame as a great jazz band. In the late 1920s and 1930s, many of the New Orleans musicians went to Europe and achieved instant fame. They planted the seed of jazz everywhere and saw it flourish particularly well in England. Over the last 50 years, Britain has produced many exceptional groups, but none that has captured the hearts of Americans as has the Max Colley Rhythm Aces. Max Colley describes the American scene from the European perspective as we listen to the Aces perform a Jelly Roll Morton classic, Black Bottom Stomp.
What's happening to traditional jazz in Europe?
I like a lot of it around there, much more than there is here. We came over here, 2 years ago, I think, the first time. We set foot on the shores of San Francisco, I think it was, September 73. And we brought the band around. We travel it around now, a long, long way. We, in the last couple of years in Europe, well, since about 1970, the rock scene's died down a lot, particularly in Germany. It's died down completely. And the traditional jazz, traditional Dixieland, New Orleans jazz, come back very, very strongly. And we're sort of over here to do that here, try and move it around. Sam, our manager, said, right, I've got the band. He's seen us and our following over there. He said, right, we need you. Come here. He's marched us about 100,000 miles around America in about 46 states in four separate tours in the last 2 years to stump it up. It's changing. I know the festivals, we've done every single festival this tour. This is an 80-day tour we've done, and we've done the Sacramento, Dixieland, Jubilee. Jerry, I saw you there. You're doing a good compare job there. And St. Louis Rag Fest, the big Beiderbecke Festival. I've done loads of Battle of the Bands in Chicago, Big Horn Jazz Festival. In all the states.
You see a resurgence of jazz in the United States thanks largely to your Europeans teaching us how, huh?
I just think we've perhaps maybe helping to tip the scales. That's what it is. I think sooner or later it would have happened here. It's a couple of bands. Now we've got some, well, you saw the Jazz Miners. We've got the little 15-year-old guys copying our stuff and records. There are several other bands like it around, high school bands, so it's just turning around now. The music scene is changing, and it's changed already in Europe around. That doesn't mean to say rock is not ever going to be big or anything like that. No, it's still gigantic. But other musics are back, and they're growing again, and jazz is one. Well, traditional New Orleans Dixieland jazz is one of them, and definitely is happening.
You're England's traditional jazz answer to the Beatles and Elton John, right?
Well, don't you think it's only fair? We started moving a lot in Hamburg. That's where they got their fame from. Our drummer's from Liverpool. Our drummer's the oldest band in the band. The folks watching might be interested in this. Ron actually opened the cabin. Ron McKay is very, very well known in Liverpool, and the Beatles used to play interval for him, and they took over. And now we're about to change it back again.
Max Colley, you've got a great following here, England, Europe, the world over. Thanks very much.
Well, thank you, Jerry. Pleasure to see you all.
Judged the most popular band of this first World Championship of Jazz, the Aces show why as they tear into another jazz masterpiece, Shimmy She Wobble.